Top of the Spectrum News.
Medical science is on the verge of revealing an absolute way of diagnosing autism. To date, behavioral observation has been the only form of getting a diagnosis. However, MRIs, or brain imaging of subjects with autism, reveal both a physical and neurological difference in typical versus autistic minds.
We're starting to look to understand the functions of the brain, and we realize that autism really is a neurobiological, I don't want to say disorder, challenge, you know, different wiring, miswiring, atypical wiring, whatever you want to call it. But we're in the fetal stage of understanding all this. And I think that once we understand this more, we'll be able to subtype this autism spectrum, you know? But right now, we know for sure that folks with Asperger have atypical function in the fusiform gyrus, which is the part of the brain that emotionally recognizes familiar people.
Janessa Manning is currently getting her doctorate at the UT Health Science Center in San Antonio, Texas. Her area of study is neuroscience imaging with a focus on discovering autistic minds.
That the brain of your child who's been newly diagnosed with high functioning autism or Asperger's is different and functions in different ways than that of a typically developing child. This is not a choice that the child is making, that we see actual neurological differences when we query both by anatomy and function. There's a great importance to getting therapy and getting treatments, well-defined, efficacious treatments, and trying to kind of improve the behaviors, but understanding that they are coming from a place of being different neurologically.